Covert to Overt. A Truth Soldier article. Okay, do you know what the words covert and overt mean? It is very important that you understand what they mean. So I will now give you from the Reader's Digest Complete Word Finder, 1996. Combination of dictionary and thesaurus. Definitions of these words. Covert. Adjective. Secret or disguised, a covert glance. Covert operations. Adjective. See secret. Overt. Adjective. Unconcealed, done openly. Apparent, evident, plain, clear, obvious, manifest, clear-cut, unconcealed, patent, visible, observable, public. Overtly. Out, in the opening, for all to see. In plain view or full view, straight out, see also openly. Okay, maybe you understand that this article is about covert agencies, be they government, corporation, or crime syndicates activities. Those of you who have deprogrammed yourselves and as a result now realize that if you are a good caring human being, have no choice but to be a truth soldier in the war against us by the New World Order corporate banksters. But if you are not an advanced thinker or a critical thinker, or an intellectual, you probably by now think that what I am choosing as my topic for this Truth Soldier article is a work of complete fiction. We'll read on, and you will soon discover that truth is always more bizarre than any fiction you'll ever read. Okay then, here is an honest question for you. Do you really believe that there are no such things as covert agencies and covert agents? Is that really possible that there are well-trained expert covert agents in our society? Covert agencies are given government license to operate. The most powerful being the government covert agencies. In Canada, that being CSIS, Canadian Secret Intelligence Service. That is because they are given unimaginable powers to access and influence anything in society. They can appear to be anyone such as a medical specialist surgeon, as they are given full authority to do anything they want as long as they do it all covertly. They will be assisted and supported by any and all government agencies and will get assistance from any member of society under the pretense of national security. They can and do alter any and all confidential records. They can and do change any of these to create the desired covert results. We the people do not understand that the only nationals they keep secure are secret society members that control the governments. But here is a huge surprise for those of you who still believe that we have a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. Meaning that we have a democracy. I hate to burst your bubble, but because of complete public apathy to what used to be our governments, has given us what we have today. We now have corporations fully controlling our governments. For all governments in Canada are now registered as corporations, who are owned by shareholders who now collect profits from the people's workers. Financial slave labor. The more credit they give you, the more powerful and useful a slave you become, who will do whatever is asked by your slave master for money, of course. Then one day you will become completely bankrupt. You will have sold your soul to the banksters. You will then be morally bankrupt. Do you realize that the only purpose for a corporate system of doing things is only for selfish financial gain and by any means? This especially means covertly. Beware when you see through the corporate image. All covert agencies have rules. They being admit nothing, Reveal nothing to always maintain your covert existence. If by chance you get discovered, do not worry, we will deny everything and no one will ever be able to substantiate that you even exist as a covert agent. So now I would like you to read my How to Assassinate a Cyclist article for a clear example of real covert activity that is done overtly in plain sight. For those of you who have been following my Truth Soldier writings over the years, you by now fully understand that everything I write is absolutely undeniably the most horrible truth of the situation in our world that has developed as a result of the creation of First Corporation, worst crime in human history. Read my article of the same name. But I especially encourage you to read my most shocking sheeple article called Are You Ready for the Truth? But if you read my very first article I ever published called Corrupt Canadian Elections, in which I describe to you what I learned in 1984 when I participated in running a federal election campaign in which the opponent was the then Solicitor General of Canada by the name of Bob Kaplan of the Liberal Party. He was in charge of all police activities in the country, making him a dangerously powerful man. During the course of the campaign I was continuously being terrorized by police. It would take a book to write everything that went on during the campaign. Suffice it to say that I soon found myself in a covert world that I did not believe existed. I did not know that Bob Kaplan created Canada's secret covert police during the campaign. That being ceases. All during the campaign I observed and discovered illegal campaign activities by the Solicitor General, who by the way was also responsible for running Elections Canada. I watched Kaplan's hired goons terrorize campaign workers, etc., etc. I watched civic workers commit serious elections crimes at the direction of the goons. I was followed, hounded day and night by police. They followed me everywhere while I worked on my responsibilities of driving all around our riding to erect and maintain our election signs. The police charged me so many times for violations and crimes I did not commit. I spent years in and out of court winning all my cases except for one where they falsely charged me with dangerous driving, where a drunk pulled out of a driveway and ran into the right side of my car as I drove by. Then I stopped and the drunk passed by me and drove into my left side while I was stopped. I will one day write out the whole event. But then one day Bob Kaplan came running out of a youth rally where he was giving speeches on democracy. I did not know he was there. I was asked to come to the neighborhood to fix all our vandalized election signs. There was international media all around me. I discovered that the Liberal Party campaigners had been the ones that obstructed our election signs contrary to federal laws. Kaplan ran right up to me and again does what he has done many times before. He verbally assaults me. At which time I thought, great, he is going to reveal his true evil character in front of media. So I will now have real witnesses. But this time he was actually threatening my life. He stood right up to my nose and screamed out these very haunting words. I am going to destroy you. We are going to make you so destitute that you will have to resort to crime to survive. And when you do, we will put you in jail where we will have fun with you. Then he lifts both his arms up to motion to his undercover goons to search every media person and threaten them to keep silent about what they just witnessed. And the goons then strip searched everyone on the public street for cameras, notes and anything else that would be incriminating. So late one night after this event, while I was out fixing an election sign, a police car pulled up and said he had a message for me. That being out, Bob Kaplan had issued a contract on me. He continued to explain what I wrote above. Except that I at that time had no knowledge of what CSIS was, as I did not know that Kaplan had created it. But I soon became a victim of what they were up to. The first thing a covert agency has to do is destroy its victim's credibility. So that if the victim ever tried to speak up, he would never be able to do anything. First, they canvass your neighborhood telling false stories about you. Then they approach your friends, family, and employers. In no time, the unsuspecting victim's life is usually destroyed. As a police officer once told me, "We can do anything we want to you, as no one will ever believe you, and you will just sound delusional and you won't be able to call for the police, as we are the ones doing it to you." Aha, ha ha ha. I would like to tell you now the worst crime against Canadian democracy I discovered. I sat there in the Progressive Conservative Party campaign office in York Centre of the city of Toronto as the vote results came in from all the polling stations. We added up all the votes and won by almost 3,000 votes. But 2 hours later, they announced on the television screen that we had lost by the same reverse total. I knew this was impossible. Please read my Corrupt Canadian Elections article to get the whole story. So now, many years later, I sit here severely injured and crippled and a prisoner in my own home. I spent many years trying to survive their covert activities to destroy my means to make a living. Here are some of my efforts and achievements, all of which were destroyed by covert activities. I worked as Dan the Handyman. I owned a renovation business. I owned cheap but good movers. I owned two shops, Towsey's Welding and Auto Repair. I owned a used goods and appliance business, Silver Spoon Trading. Please read my related article, The Harm Storm. So now we arrive at my point about overt. The danger is when they go overt, where they strike controversial conversations with you, and then the system will take your views and assassinate you for having them. Yes, this is for real. There are agents that seek out political activist truth soldiers that are published writers. Then they will silence your words of truth forever. Anyone who seeks the truth and then speaks the truth is to be silenced forever. That is their agenda. Agents have now become overt in Canada. They can and do professionally assassinate Canadians on public streets and in broad daylight. Read my code to assassinate a cyclist. Covert has been allowed to happen in a free and open society, and now we have a closed and secret society controlling everything because the good people have been bought off by the credit economic system. But society is now doomed, for it is no longer guided by the light of truth. It is now being absorbed into the opposite of truth, and that being the black hole of insanity. Truth is an absolute, and insanity is absolutely the opposite. I have always said that if mankind is not guided into the future by truth, then we are all doomed. Are you part of the solution, or are you only part of the problem? If you do not learn the truth soon and tell everyone, then you will not survive. Please read my "They Want You Dead" written is stone article. And wake up before this becomes the end. http://danieltowsey.wordpress.com http://danieltowsey.photoshop.com. Commentary by http://vaticproject.blogspot.com. Mossad comes to America, death squads by invitation. The big question is, how many prominent Americans have also either been assassinated by the squad or seriously wounded? It's time to begin to ask the hard questions. The CIA did not have domestic assassination squads until the Neocons came into power under Cheney and continued under Reagan. And Lord knows who else now. And all that changed, and we are beginning to look more and more like Israel and beginning to act more and more like Nazis. Project Paperclip, ring a bell? It's time to start a brutally hard look with all these recent assassinations, like we learn attempted mind control assassination of Gibbons, and the deaths of others in that parking lot. It's time someone said, who and where are these squads and where are the records for the United States to see who domestically they have eliminated within our government or high up in civilian life? Like JFK Jr. We need to demand some answers and to ask our reps and senators the hard question. What is this squad doing functioning domestically in a democratic republic called the USA? It shouldn't even be functioning in any foreign country either. Let's get some information and let's shine the light of day on the dark evil pervading this nation. Don't you think it's about time? Iceland had the right idea. Reply by Linda Jocelyn on April 16, 2010. Thank you for this article. I am glad someone else is willing to speak up about harassment that happens when you speak the truth. I have some tales to tell myself going back many years, starting when I was a land activist and had the nightmare drive of my life when the driver of a car I was in suddenly went into some sort of trance, put their foot down and began to drive at top speed along a country road. When we caught up with the next person on that road, she rammed them and then overtook the line of three cars. As a meditator, I went into high alertness, stared the car across her and affirmed to myself and upstairs that was not ready to die. After 4 miles of horror, I managed to apply handbrake slowly and steer off the road. From the ramming incident, front of car was completely smashed in and smoke pouring out of vehicle. When I said, get out of the car, it's going to go up. She smiled and said, I am tired now, and laid down across the seats. Sounds like a movie scene, so you can imagine I did not tell many people about it apart from other activists who knew that covert mind control methods were being used sometimes. I had been the coordinator of our group and had walked the people onto this particular site. We were squatting against a big corporation. She was tested in many different ways at the hospital, but they never found anything wrong. The police and ambulances hit the scene as we were reported as hit and run merchants. Needless to say, it took me off the site for 3 months with post-traumatic shock. I dealt with at the time incredibly well, but when you jump levels like that, you get a throwback later. When I was defending an eviction case that had been brought against my organic cafe and organic milling business, I was litigating for myself, which they hate, because no deals can be done and they see you as a complete loose cannon. 3 days before the last time in court, my house was broken into and a man came into my bedroom. He supposedly walked 26 miles in the rain in his slippers and had escaped from a local mental hospital, owned and run by the people I was in court against, the local council. Again, because I remained calm at the time, he told me that he had a secret rendezvous with someone, and when I said I think you ought to go now and let him out, he hung around and didn't know what to do. Recently, I have had to learn about protection from ELF waves, electronic low-frequency waves, and whatever else they are using. Also, I have learned to use my mind differently because they can pick up your unique energy signature and read your mind. Sounds fantastical, but it's true. I have learned to talk back to them and call them on their conscience. I have had many experiences with black helicopters, but also one strange event with an aircraft coming straight at me. Very strange aircraft. Never seen anything like it. But the whole scene was distracted by an accident on the road. The art of survival is to stay super conscious and aware. I always key in with upstairs, as I call the higher beings, before I journey out of my area, and get guidance on every possible hurdle on the journey and ask for protection. That day I knew in advance that something was planned, but when it actually happened I could not really believe it and was shouting out, "Oh my God! They are really going to do it!" I truly believe that what happened next, as I was trying to look for somewhere to pull off onto another road, was upstairs, diverting the problem. The plane veered off to the right and I just drove on around the accident and ignored the police car that was screaming up behind me. I believe that because of my networking over the web and because of the importance of the information in my channel books from the higher beings that I am seen as some sort of threat. I have no fear of what is going on because they are operating on a much lower frequency and I am given direction from the higher beings. Protection is in learning how to raise your vibration. They want you to be in fear. It stops all of your higher knowledge, intuition, wisdom, and protection. The way to go is to learn mastery through meditation, awareness techniques, and raising consciousness. Remember, in the now moment it is impossible to feel fear. Reply by George Schilling. Daniel, I read your blog and agree that the story needs to be told. It is incredible what you went through and probably still are. I was going to try and post the blog on my blog page with your name on it, but couldn't copy it to paste. You may want to try another format before you try and post it. If I can help in any way, let me know. Keep up the good fight. You have friends with empathy for your situation. Good luck, my friend. Signed, George. Reply by Prophet. Never let those bastards silence you, Danny. Your story is undeniably incomprehensible. I hope I can make it to Nova Scotia, New Scotland, someday and meet you. Keep shining light. There are more and more each day that are beginning to comprehend. Reply by Daniel J. Towsey, a truth soldier, on May 10, 2010. Yes, there are more every day beginning to understand, but unfortunately they resort to fear to guide their thoughts. They do not realize that fear is exactly why the New World Order Mafia is succeeding. The sheeple do not understand that we all need to seek the truth and speak the truth of the evils in this world. For our silence will guarantee our death. It may not be a physical death for now, but it surely will be the death of our souls and freedoms. Remember this, all good people are under attack. The insane, with their power to create money out of thin air, are going to destroy all that is beautiful. There is only one solution, and that is for the sheeple to wake up and stop using the credit system. Become independent and self-sufficient. The credit system is enslaving humanity. Anyway, I am happy with this site. It is full of great intelligent people. And I always appreciate the comments. Bye for now, fellow truth soldiers. I will meet you in the end.